One C long, Reyna.
You will not kill my ally! Jets grounded!
One, two. Sorry.
Oh my god!
This alpha of a man is Is Sinatraa Juan, and he is known in the Valorant community for his brain dead outbursts.
Nice! What happened?
At least his outbursts aren't as bad as Shazam's. This man literally yells after anything.
Winnable, guys.
Oh my god, we won!
Shut the fuck up!
Sinatraa's story at times can be really sad, but he definitely has one of the best comeback stories in the Valorant community.
Well, I've been afraid of changing, cause I built my life around you.
Like any other kid ever, Sinatraa loved playing video games, and whenever she got the chance, Sinatraa's mom would take him to Chuck E. Cheese. He also, for some reason, loved exploring caves. As Jay got older, he started resenting school. He felt like it was a big waste of time, so he decided to drop out during his junior year. Not many well-paying jobs wanted to hire Jay because he was a dropout, so he decided to work at McDonald's. Then Jay's life became very stagnant, working at McDonald's for 5 years. His life was pretty shitty, but there was one good thing about working at McDonald's. There was this girl that worked there named Emmy, and Jay thought she was pretty cute. They started talking and hanging out, and pretty soon they started dating. Jay had been scrawny his whole life, and he started to get tired of it. So, he decided to do something about it.
Big body bins, remember I used to be dusty. Big body bins, remember I used to be dusty. Big body bins, remember I used to be dusty.
Big body bins, remember I used to be dusty. Now I want my money, I want to see.
You know what I mean?
Late at night, Emmy and Jay were walking home after a date when three guys walking by them started catcalling towards Emmy. One of the guys reached out to put his hands on her when Jay started swinging, knocking all of them out. Jay didn't walk away unscathed. He suffered blows to the eye for doing the most noble thing anyone can do, defending their girlfriend. Valorant came out, and of course, he started playing it. Since he would play all the time, he'd become very good and decided to start streaming. He picked the name Sinatraa because, fuck man, I don't know. Expect me to know everything. Fuck. He would stream himself dropping high kill games on Valorant, and every now and then, he would show us how dominant he was at scribble.io.
What the fuck are the- Ouch.
Okay. Just look at the letters at the top so you know how, like, how many, you know. Okay.
What color is this?
Yeah. Dude, I typed fire truck every day for like 2 days.
And then the one round, it was it.
He made a name for himself when he reached number one on the Valorant leaderboards. Tenz was recently dropped from Sentinels after he killed talk show host Jake Lucky. Sentinels was in dire need of a fifth, so Shazam reached out to Jay and asked him if he wanted to join the team. With the announcement of Sinatraa joining Sentinels, more and more people were finding out about his stream. The reason his streams were so successful is because he followed an ideology known as being brain dead. This ideology was popularized in the early 2000s by popular philosopher Confucius. Confucius once said, "One's inner self first needs to understand how to be brain dead before they can shoot the brain to make them dead."
Okay, you're not that good.
That's actually cringe. That's actually cringe, bro. That's just cringe.
Are you guys-
Sinatraa studied this mindset, and that's why his streams are so successful. By him shouting out brain-dead catchphrases like,
"That's a glitch." Thanks. Oh, okay. These guys are different in the head.
I'm dead.
More and more people were becoming interested in his streams. The more viewers you have, the more stream snappers you'll get. Sinatraa had a lot of stream snappers, but there was one that stood out from the rest.
I would jerk off on stream and Jay, you know what I'm saying?
Someone who would terrorize Sinatraa on a day-to-day basis.
I don't know, bro. I'll probably just get dick down, bro. I really need dick right now.
This stream sniper was so dedicated that he changed his name to I Love That Boy Jay Wong and would constantly Q-snipe him so they could be in the same team. I Love That Boy Jay Wong.
Why do you snipe me, man?
I wasn't. I swear this time.
Yeah?
I'm bro, on
everything. What is this, man? What does this time mean? What does this time mean?
This time, I maybe.
What is this time?
Dude, I was snapping the rate.
He would cue snipe Jay so much that it eventually got annoying. He finally told him that if he didn't stop, he would get him banned. Love Dat.
You snipe me one more time, bro, you're permaban.
But this didn't stop I Love Dat boy Jay Wong. He found loopholes.
For real.
Is that Love Dat?
I can't be away for long.
No.
Let's end this quickly.
Is that Love Dat?
No.
You turn your name off to snipe me this time?
Yes.
Oh, bro.
Chill, bro. Chill. I can't play.
That's actually cringe, bro. That's actually cringe.
I just want to play with you, bro.
Riot Games eventually banned him. Even though he was kind of an annoying kid, Sinatraa and I Love Dat boy Jay Wong had some good times together, and he will be missed.
Cap.
On January 17th, 2021, Sinatraa would say a line that would win him an Oscar. Right then and there, he would make a new word that everyone in the Valorant community would leech onto and overuse, therefore making it not funny.
It's fine?
One day, Sinatraa let out a sheesh so strong that it sent him to another dimension. VCT Masters was right around the corner, the first Valorant LAN. This meant that Sentinels had to lock in. But 3 months before the tournament, Hiko was playing against Sinatraa. He was getting shit on so bad that he accused Sinatraa of stream sniping. These allegations led to Sinatraa being suspended from Valorant Pro Play and Riot Games conducting a full-blown investigation on the matter. He stopped streaming for a month. This left his fans wondering what the future for Sinatraa was like. Sinatraa responded to these allegations, saying that they obviously weren't true and that he was ready to go to court to fight for his innocence. On July 20th, 2021, Sinatraa and Hiko met up in court and presented their cases towards the judge. Hiko went in front of the jury, trying to ruin Jay's character by stating a bunch of things that just weren't true, while Jay was calm and only had one thing to say.
What?
Jay won the case and was given $100,000 for defamation of character. On August 3rd, after not streaming for 3 months straight, he turned on his stream to 25,000 people flooding in, excited to see him back. He finished the court case just 10 days before VCT Masters at Reykjavik. He practiced 12 hours a day with his team and went on to Iceland to beat Hiko's team, 100 Thieves, in the grand finals. After the tournament, things went back to normal. Sinatraa resumed daily streaming, and Emmy and Jay moved in together. But Jay was in dire need of a new duo partner, since he got tired of Zom's baiting 24/7.
Zom, peek!
Bro, what do you want me to do against this shit?
Like, peek, obviously, you heard him.
Oh, enemy's aiming.
No.
Peek, bro!
What?
Yo, peek! I don't care, Pete!
Jay was walking down the street one day when he saw a homeless man. He asked him what his name was, and the man said,
I am Wildman.
Jay asked him if he needed any money, and Wildman said no, but I need someone to play Valorant with. Sinatraa got his username, and they started playing on stream together, and right away, the fans could see that this was a good dynamic.
One enemy remaining.
Please. Shut the fuck up! What? Please, suck my ass or head!
What?
Stop fucking talking, okay? Whoa. I'm playing the game! Shut the fuck up!
Whoa, man.
Watch my asshole! Shut the fuck up!
Their duo became so iconic that the website whatimeisitrightnow.com approached them, asking them if they wanted to do a show. Sinatraa said, Wildman said,
I'm Wildman.
It was a yes from both of them, and right then and there, the adventures of Sinatraa and Wildman was born. The show was an immediate success, spawning countless funny moments, like when Jay slept with Wow Man's girlfriend.
I'm already smashing, man.
Oh my god!
Fucking idiot, get the fuck out of my chat. Okay. Or I come back over, Osley.
Oh no, no, don't do that. BTFT.
Since Jay was making 25k an episode, he decided to leave the Valorant pro scene. And me and Jay would go on to have a son. They named him Mackelson.
Look at the screen, Mac.
That's you.
He's unimpressed.
But unfortunately, Mac has a problem with eating everything but his food.
Hey! Wait, Emma, put your glasses away. Fuck. He's just gonna eat her glasses. Hey. What the fuck are you doing? Why are you eating my chair? Stop. Stop eating my chair, mister.
But they still love him anyway. Sinatraa's story has a lot of hardship, but he didn't let any of these things stop him. He came out on top and is an inspiration to many.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than...